reorganize our own self, personally also and professionally also. So this is an opportunity for us to learn from an expert on what we can do as far as we can think of writing down or writing papers in journals, and with this motto and with few other we have started with this special department in our KGP Children Hospital with the help of advisors as Dr. Jagdish Patel sir, Dr. Arun Phatak sir, and Dr. Niranjan Shindunikar sir. And there is this core team, and all the consultants are working towards doing something on this front. So with this, I request Dr. Niranjan Shindunikar, who is head of department and of Department of Pediatrics and advisor to this Department of Clinical Research, my teacher also, to introduce the speaker for today, Dr. Jyotirmay Pal. Dr. Niranjan Shindunikar, sir, please. Hello.
Okay. You are audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay. Good evening, Tushar. Good evening. On behalf of KG Patel Children's Hospital and Professor Sanath Shah Research Trust, I have a great chance to welcome you all and our esteemed speaker for today's session. Normally, we have been going through a lot of webinars and all of online presentations, particularly with the therapeutics and all the diagnostics. So, this is a change for us to hone our writing skills. And Dr. Tushar has said rightly what we need to do for writing. And who can be better than having one of our eminent faculties amongst us to give us a good view over the subject. It is our great pleasure and privilege to have Dr. Jyotirmay Pal with us today for interactions. He is a professor of medicine at R.J. Kerr Medical College in Kolkata. And let me just highlight those of whom who are not aware, it is one of the most prestigious and one of the oldest medical colleges in India, which has celebrated around 100 years in 2016. So he's an eminent faculty and he's a professor of medicine. Also, he's also a very active editor of Journal of Indian Medical Association, which is one of the widest circulations in India and abroad. He's plus a vice president of Association of Physicians of India. And he's a very prolific writer of medical articles, and he has published lots of articles in peer-reviewed scientific journals, both nationally and internationally. So it's a great pleasure to have you, sir, amongst us. And I'm very sure that we take home very clear messages and start working with our pens also, and writing also, and contributing to the betterment of medical fraternity. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Sir, I'll stop sharing so that you can share your screen. Sir, you can unmute yourself, and I request you to share your screen.
Thank you. Good afternoon for inviting me in such a prestigious program organized by Indian Medical Association, Gujarat. First I like to mention that I am very happy that you are taking such a initiative, particularly at the period when you are passing through a biggest challenge of the century, that is the COVID pandemic. COVID, correctly you have mentioned that COVID has given us opportunity to introspect. Why introspect? Because we Indians, after the independence, we have advanced a lot, whether economically, technologically, it's for medical science and different aspect, infrastructure growth and others. But still we are lacking in terms of research of the medical science and also in other field also. This is evidenced by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. He has declared or he has established 100 MRU in 100 medical colleges. But unfortunately, most of the IMRU is not functioning till now properly because this is the lack of our attitude towards research. And this makes the difference between the East and the West. In the West, there is a habit of whatever they observe, whatever they investigate, whatever they found something unnatural, they go on writing. And the next generation pick up and start from that point. For example, if I give a history of discovery of iodine, it is the soldier of Napoleon. He used to clean his firearms with some H2SO4 every day. One day, excessive H2SO4 was given on some gunpowder, and he observed some pink color vapor is coming out. He has not understood anything, but he has written the phenomena. He expired. After 100 years, that literature, that paper was seen by another soldier. And he started same procedure. And he also observed same flame is coming, pink color is coming from the gunpowder. So he observed. Again, he understood. He has not understood anything, but he has written. He has documented. And another 25 to 30 years, I forget the name, then he discovered it is basically the iodine. And he is giving the name. He discovered the compound iodine that is responsible, that is coming out from the reaction with H2SO4. Details I actually forget. So in this way, the iodine was discovered. And this discovered basically somebody has gone writing his observation and next generation has picked up his observation. But on the contrary, in the East, our ancient India was very much strong in different observational science, but nothing was documented. That is our deficit. That is why West is much ahead in scientific discovery than the East. But intellectually, we are not less than the West. So this is very important that you have taken initiative to update, not only update, I think to instigate your member to go for more. One part is research, one part is writing. If you go for research and do not write anything, do not publish, people will come to know. It is of no use. You enjoyed doing the research, but if you cannot publish, if the next generation or other people cannot benefit it from your research or cannot carry out your work, your work is of no use. So in one end, you have to do the research that your department is doing, how to do the research, how to do the either observational study or randomized control study. But whatever you do after your research, after your observation, scientifically, you have to document. So amount of writing of a profession is a measure of its vitality and activity, where quality is a rough indication of his intellectual state. So as an introduction, I want to mention that research and publication should go hand by hand. So whatever you have the research, if you do not write the paper correctly, you cannot get the full benefit, or not only you, the other people cannot get the best benefit. So research and in research, like research methodology, in paper writing also there is a methodology. Both should be perfect. Otherwise, you will not. It is of no use. So there is there is two way. One is author, one is reader. I am author. I am writing, and you are reader. So author have to understand the psychology of the reader. What is author psychology? Author psychology want to publish more. I want to publish 100 publication, 200 publication, 300 publication, and I want to put in my CV. So I am a so great man. I have 300 publication, but reader want to read less. So they want to read less, but want more benefit. So you have to be very precise when you are writing. Author have to think what I am writing, and then I will come where you are writing. That is very important. In which journal, who are the reader? That you have to keep in mind. When you are publishing something in any GM, your reader is some different too. When you are going to my journal, this is GMA, your reader is something else. In IMA journal, there is a 3 lakhs reader. So many of the readers are not specialists. So you have to think for them also. If you write in a very much complicated way, only the research product, all lot of statistical issues you put, readers will not get the benefit or may not read, because we have to remember that most of the readers of our not of teacher and also the general practitioner. So you have to, when as the editor I choose the article, I choose whether I always keep remember who are my readers, whether it will be directly benefited. So if a article, suppose I will put an article on a peripheral blood smear that I have put in few months back, or this month I have put an article on wound healing, because this is very important, even not only the surgeon, also the general practitioner, because day to day practice we are facing this issue. So as a editor, I will choose those article that is useful for most of our readers. When NEJMA will choose an article, they will choose who are their readers. Because when the ICMR is advocating any drug, he is taking reference from NEJM, BMJ, like this. So best of quality, best of the statistical analysis should be present when you are putting article in NEJM, and their editor also choose the article accordingly. Because most of the health authority will plan or health planning according to the report from those journal. You have to confess the truth at the beginning. So readers priority should be the easy to access. So previously JIMA was only the print version. So now I have made the online version, because and also available in Jio app. So that when you are traveling in your car to go to your hospital or working place, you can read it. So easy to access. Anytime you can download. Anytime you can take print out and you can read it anywhere in the world. Suppose today you are in the Western countries. Now JIMA has been published. Go for www.onlinejima.com, download and read. So easy to access is very important. Rapid delivery. If there is an online version, the day yesterday I have released the October issue. Today it is available in the online. So rapid delivery is possible in the online version. So both print version and online version is very important for the today's journal. Convenient format. And linking for the information, clustering, and low and no cost. So cost should be minimum. If you have to purchase the high cost, the readers will not be motivated to read the journal. And up-to-date information. Your information should be up-to-date. If any article is accepted in 2016, before putting in 2020, I sent. That may be cleared 2016 by some referee, but again I send to the referee, because whether the information provided in 2016 till now valid, whether till now has any relevance, or science has changed. Suppose 2016 some drug was relevant, but 2019 that has been declared is of no use. So if I put the article that is accepted in 2016 without re-evaluating by some other evaluator, it will have no use, and you may not read. Even you can criticize. So up-to-date information is very important for the reader's viewpoint and editor's viewpoint. So difference between authors and journal. Authors are basically journal focused, but readers are article focused. That is also another distinguishing feature between authors and readers. Because authors, when you are author, you have done some research work, you will choose a journal. You will choose a journal. In which journal, which is the impact factor is more, you will choose that journal. But, or in a journal that is circulated more. That is why many of the authors nowadays prefer JIMA, because it is a wide circulation. 3 lakh people get also online. But there are some India, there is more journalists there whose impact factor is more, but not widely circulated. So in my experience, I have seen many of the authors, they prefer the Journal of Indian Medical Association. So they divide the research on two parts. One part they probably send to a journal who has a high impact factor. Another part is sent to the JIMA for the wide publication. But readers are article focused. Readers, suppose you are nephrologist, you will search an article which is basically on nephrology. suppose you are general practitioner, you will choose the article which is more focused on the infectious disease. Suppose this month I have put an article on tuberculin test. I know most of the 90% of our readers will read the article, because tuberculin test is prescribed by every physician of our country today or tomorrow. So when I put this article, I know 90% readers will read this article. But if I put an article on some technological issue, or artificial intelligence in management of cardiac disease, I think very less people, readers will read it, because it is highly sophisticated. Most of the our members do not need it, but tuberculin test is needed by every of our members. So you have to as an editor, you have to understand the priority of the readers. And I always focus on whatever I receive the articles. I always give the priority of who are my readers and how they will be benefited, and whether they will be at all benefited if I publish this article. This I always keep in mind. So key element, one is ethical issue, style and language, structure, component, article submission issue, and publisher's process on peer review. I will come one by one in brief. What is the ethical issue? Why ethical issue is important? Because whether there is a disclosure conflict of interest, whether with this article some conflict of interest is there. Suppose one article is going against, suppose one somebody has done a research on a drug, okay, but that is sponsored by someone, some pharma company. But in our guideline, in the Government of India guideline, this drug is not approved. So I have a conflict of interest. So I have to keep this issue in mind also. So another is the acknowledgement of funding source. You have to disclose what are the funding source. Then the image manipulation, whether the image that you put in the article is taken from the any other article that is not royalty free. Because there is a copyright. Suppose I have taken an article I have taken a picture that is published in NEGM. So NEGM has not given permission. So if I publish that image, it can be trouble for me. So there is two type of image is there. One is royalty free, one is royalty not free. For royalty free article, you can take from that, you can download and put it in article. But some article has a copyright. So you have to take the permission. So when I get the image, my publisher always go on searching whether it is taken from royalty free section or it has a copyright. If there is a copyright is there, I will ask my author to take a permission from that particular journal to send the permission to me. Usually in my experience, if you are honest, the other publishers give the permission to use that image, with condition that they will mention that this image is taken from this journal and by this author in here, this and this. So then there's online submission. Now it is available. Most of the journal also in GIMA. And another important ethical issue that I want to mention, whether you can publish any article, but you have to, as the editor, you have to remember whether this publication, after post publication of the article, whether can create a political, religious, racial turbulence. I recently got an article from UK written by some Indian doctor settled there, and he is definitely a Bengali. He called me and sent an article. He told me it's a very good article, go on reading. I go through the article, I have seen there are a lot of racial issues, that may be true. But if I put this article and he has written in a strong language, then I realize that can create a turbulence, because this is not a newspaper. In newspaper, you can publish that article with your responsibility or your vision. But in a medical journal, that is the attitude of some British government or Indian. They are, I don't know, it's true and fact. I am not in a position to justify how much it is true, how much it is not true. But I have put a cold feet on the article, because I thought that can create some political turbulence if I publish the article. So these are the ethical issue that the author should remember, should keep in mind, or say editors should keep in mind. It's the style of the language. Style of the language, some author write their paper with a scientific journal in mind. Others adopt it. And an objective is to report your finding and conclusion clearly and concisely as possible. So your style of language should be so clear that the author can understand very clearly. Your attitude, whenever you do a teaching or whenever you do a writing, if you can make the complicated thing very easy, that means you have a grasp of the subject. So you have to write very clearly and precisely so that to be understood by the author. And with a different level of education, authors would have a different level of education, different level of aptitude. Your writing will be so that all level, you have to keep the issues of the readers in your mind. So style and language is very important. In India, we usually use the English language. So now you're preparing for the write-up. So remember, whatever writing, to communicate, not to impress. So first, you are neutral. You are not going to impress anybody. What are the scientific facts? You are going on narrating. That is more important. And realize the journal editor and peer reviewer reading your work want to do well. The purpose of the constructive criticism is to help you succeed. When you send the article, sometimes we accept, sometimes we send some criticism. Criticism does not mean we are negating your work. That is, we are helping. We are helping the author that you have done this work, but you have not thought in this way. So I am giving some input to the author so the author can think and rethink and can rewrite or take some time to reinvestigate the issue. So criticism by our peer reviewers is basically should have a positive impact on the author. So you select the journal where you want to publish, and as per the journal's policy and as a journal style, you go on writing your article. So before writing, every journal has a journal instruction to the author. First you go through the, almost all journals are more or less same. There may be some difference. So journal's instruction to the author, very important before doing the writing. Make an outline of your paper, break down the writing process into steps, and schedule specific times to write up. Assign a due date for each step. Make weekly or daily priority list. Start and use word processing to write more efficiently. That means if you start writing, you fix up date that I will finish by next 2 weeks or 1 month. And I will spend, introduction, I'll end by this week. Material method next second week. Observation third week. Discussion fourth week. Fifth week, I will revise the entire thing. Sixth week, I send to the journal. So this is the time-bound space unless you cannot achieve your goal. So structure of a paper. Scientific writing should follow a rigid structure, and every article has a structure. I am coming, and that start from the introduction, method, result, and discussion. And before that, you should have some title. You have to fix up the title. You have to fix up the abstract. You have to fix up the keyword. Then introduction, material method, result, and discussion. And another 2 points will come. Conclusion, take-home message. We Jima always take the take-home message, because I realized when I was a reader, then I realized what I have done. Now I am editor, but at a point of time, I was reader. Sometimes I have not so much time to read the whole article. What I do, I have read the abstract. And even if I have no time to read the abstract, I go to the take-home messages. That is 4-5 lines take-home message. Whenever, if you send the article, you always say, my office send a mail to you, please send take-home message in 3-4 lines. Because I always keep mind of the different authors. Some reader will go through the entire paper. Some will read the abstract. Some will read only the take-home message. 3-4 lines they will take, whether this drug can be used in severe case of COVID, whether this drug can be used in mild to moderate case of COVID. Contraindication, it is like this. This drug can be used in severe case. This drug should be used between 5 to 10 days. Renal hepatic dysfunction is a contraindication. Pregnancy is a contraindication. It is like this. So 3-4 take-home message so that readers can apply this your knowledge in practice. He has not gone through what research you have done on particular drug and effects on COVID. But he has take-home message 3-4 line and he is going to apply this knowledge in his practice. So this is why take-home message, in my opinion, very important for every article. So titles, then the author's name, as per chronology, then the abstract, keywords, introduction, method, result, discussion, acknowledgement, who have helped you, references, very important, and appendices. So these are the different component of a paper. So now I am coming one by one. Title should be very, very convincing. So title should be like this, that what do you do? When you get a journal, you take the content page. Okay. You may not have time to read the whole article. You read the titles. Suppose in original, there is 6 original article. You read the title, which is best or which is more suitable for your practice. So title should be not like this, a barking dog in a full moon. It should not be like this. It should be very comprehensive. A 30 years male, suppose you are writing a case report. 30 years male with sudden onset chest pain with hemoptysis. So that something is a strike in my mind. If the young male come with chest pain and hemoptysis, what can be the DD and whether the author or investigator had got something unusual, whether he has got, whether that is that unusual thing, I can have the idea that it can be this disease. It is like this. So your title will give some impression or create enthusiasm or interest to the subject. So this is very important. So do not use abbreviation or jargon. Describe the paper's content very clearly and precisely, including the keywords. So abstract, it should be brief, not more than 150 to 200 words. It should be very brief. And abstract also gives the problem, method, results, and conclusion. When we are asked to give some lecture on some issue, or you are supposed to present something, many times there may be on that issue, there will be 30-40 articles, but you may not have time to read the 30-40 articles, not because tomorrow morning you have to present it. What do? We download and read the abstract. What are the articles that has talked in favor of this item, or who have talked against this item? So we see the abstract, we summarize and go. So abstract is very important because in our experience, most of the readers read only abstract. If want to go in depth, then only read the whole article. So abstract is very important. Should not be more than 150 to 200. Also, this also contain the problem of why you have conduct the study, the methodology, the result, and conclusion. Everything it should contain. So next, the keyword. Keyword should be 3 to 10 keyword and selected from the title and abstract. And also can be selected from the standard list. So keyword not more than 3 to 10 words, and keyword issue so that you by the keywords, what are the, so by the keyword you can easily can guess what is the content of the whole article. So abstract, title, if you do not time to read the abstract also, the title and keyword can give you some idea what can be the content of the whole article. So introduction, briefly, basically introduction is give a summarize why your research is relevant, why you have started this work. That is important for the introduction. So by introduction, you have brought the readers within the arena of the of your research problem. So quickly readers have entered in your area where you want to research or where you want to focus by your work. So this is very important introduction. Introduction will be very catchy, and with the introduction give a overview of the whole research issue. So in introduction, first paragraph with the topic of the paper, what is the issue, what is the whether anti this suppose metformin is useful in this type of situation. The first paragraph will depict the topic of the paper, and middle paragraph will give the literature review. What are the evidence? Why you have? Because your research work basically the continuation of the previous study. So from the background knowledge, you have gone forward. So you should have some background knowledge that suppose metformin in some indication. So you should have some knowledge that metformin is useful. Whether metformin is useful for this is the condition. Now you are going ahead. You are introducing some more new arena on metformin. And final paragraph, justification and how you are introducing to the research area. There is a roadmap. So three-part introduction should be there. In the literature review, I already told. So literature review and bibliography or reference, you have to mention from where you have taken the reference and what are the previous works on which basis you have started your new work. So when you are writing the literature review, mostly use the past tense and arrange mostly in chronological order. Suppose you want to write something on metformin, so you will mention in 1960 what are the indication, then 1970 what are the indication, 1980 what are the indication, and 2000 what are the indication. Now why 2020 you want to use metformin, some other newer indication. So arrange mostly in the chronological order, and then logical connection should be there between the studies. And you can put some summary table. You can put a summary. So there's the 10 studies there on this item, and 10 study done by this year, this, and this is the result. So this is the previous, suppose you are doing remdesivir, that is used now. You can put a table. So these are the following study done on this drug. These are the person who have conducted. This is the year. This is the published paper where this study was published. And this is the summary of the result. In 9 studies telling that effect of this drug is very good on that why disease. But one study had told that effect is not so good. So summary table is very important for the readers. So now the methodology should be perfect. Because if the methodology, what you have written, that should be scrutinized by the statistician. Because methodology, suppose I published a paper, but methodology, if noticed by our readers or by statistician, the methodology is not, the conclusion cannot be perfect. So methodology should be perfect, and you should, in your article, you mention what methodology you have adopted. That is important. So that our statistician, our reviewer, our expert can understand why you have applied, why this statistical method is appropriate for this study. That we also deal. Because if methodology is wrong, your result will be wrong, your conclusion will be wrong, wrong message will go to the medical community. So method content, though describe the context and setting of the study, specific the study's design, that is very important. Study design, because another aspect is there. If somebody want to follow your study, suppose you have done a study on 100 population, and what you have done, very important. Suppose you have done the retrospective cohort study, or you have done the prospective cohort study for six months, you should mention, because second investigation can continue your study for another 2 years. So if you mention what you have done, then describe the population on whom you have done this study, whether this prophylaxis, effect of prophylaxis, you have done on the patients, you have done on the doctors, you have done on the hospitals. And this is very important, because on whom you have done, but result will vary. because result will vary. If you ECG prophylaxis, if you put on the doctor, some result will be there, because they are continuously they are being exposed to the virus from the patient. But general population is not so much exposed. So when you are doing the study, result will be different. So you have to separate patient population or doctor, or general population versus doctor. You cannot mix it. If you want to study effect of prophylaxis of HCQ, you have to put this population separately, because their characteristics is something different. Describe the sampling strategy, how I have done the randomization. This is very important. Your department is the research methodology. They know better than me how we'll do the sampling strategy. There is a statistical model and intervention, whether it is a observational study or we have done the RCT study, whether the double blind, triple blind, whatever the procedure you apply, that you should mention in the study. And study variable, another very important data collection instrument, how we have collected data, what is the methodology and analysis method. This is everything. This is the most important part. This is the most important part of writing a paper, and that give the idea how good study is your work. So amount of details to use, brief description of the method, and when you have the methodology citation of the reference, you have to do whether the same method was followed by some other author in some other places, published in some other journal. So that also you have to mention that this methodology was applied, same methodology by some author in this journal and got this result, but I am getting this result. So detailed description of methodology and citation from the reference also very important. So methodology should be written in past tense, because you have completed the work. And journal use the subheading. You may include the tables figure, for example, flowchart, diagram, tables of experimental condition. What are the results you have done? If you present with tables and figures, that become very catchy or better to understand. If you put the histogram, or if you put the result in pie chart, without reading, the author can understand very, very easily. Suppose you put a pie chart or the comorbidity of the COVID. In a pie chart, you have shown that mostly it is diabetic or hypertension, 40% diabetes. So I may not read the whole line, but if I see the pie chart, I can understand what is the number one comorbidity, what is the number two comorbidity very easily. Also for editors also, we can easily understand what you want to say. Whether my readers will be benefited from this study. So result, next is coming to the result. Very precisely you have to, because this is the more, after methodology and result. So you explain your result, what you got from of your study. So you have to put the result very logically and use as much as tables, figure, and to answer the question of hypothesis. There's a hypothesis on the beginning of the study, whether you are rejecting the hypothesis or you are accepting the hypothesis, and you present very logically. But description should be very brief, providing the reader sufficient information to know whether data was produced. So result, this is the core of the paper. Report of data collection and recruitment. Describe the participants, demography, the clinical condition, etc. Otherwise there will be confusion. And present key finding with respect to the central research question. Present secondary finding, secondary outcome. Primary outcome and secondary outcome, and all the details you present by preferably tables and figures that the editors prefer. So tables or figure, every time I am giving importance, but tables and figure give it is useful for the readers. Quickly they can understand what is the what the researcher want to present. So common mistakes. The common mistakes: inaccurate data, repetition of the data, misplaced information between the methods and results section, inappropriate presentation of the data, overuse or abuse the tables and figures, and attempt to draw conclusion. This should be covered in discussion section. So discussion and conclusion. Describe what your results mean in context. what was already known for the subject. Indicate how the result relate to the expectation and literature previously cited. Explain how the research has been moved the body of the scientific knowledge forward. And do not extend your conclusion beyond what is directly supported by your result. So conclusion, after your result, you drop the conclusion. What is the difference of your study compared to the previous study? You can put a chart that these are the 10 study that given this result, not in favor, but my study has given in favor of my hypothesis. And this, and also you have to mention why your result is something different from previous study. That give a strength of your study. That become catchy to your reader, because on that basis, if 9 studies against the hypothesis and only 1 study is in favor of hypothesis, and you have very good logic, the next researcher on the basis of your study again can proceed for the further study. So one of the most difficult part is to write, because whatever good work you have done, if you cannot write properly, your effort, your investment, your time will go in of no use. So writing is very important. How you are presenting, that is very important. So often begin with a brief summary of the main finding and go on describing the every aspect of your research work in your paper. So common mistakes are repetition of the data present in the result section. Do not repeat. That gives them some wrong impression. And incorrect interpretation of the finding. Finding, whatever you do, that should be interpreted very, very, very clearly. And importance of result inadequately discussed or omitted. Whatever you have given in the result section, every point to be discussed in the discussion section. And conclusions should be supported by your finding. You draw a conclusion, but that is not supported by the findings, that will be rejected by the editor. Irrelevant point should be omitted, and failure, and you always try to failure your weakness and mention this is the lacuna of your study. You fail to do, or you fail to focus on this point for this purpose. So you are mentioning your lacuna in your paper. More, your aim is the next researcher on that will not do the mistake or will to cover up the lacuna of the present article and go ahead with the next stage of research. So relevant reference should not be omitted. So most important relevant reference should be mentioned. You may not put a reference of 100, 200, but relevant reference should be there. And explanation should not be too long. You will lose the interest. Explanation should be brief and to the point. So summarize the example of the styles. Now the acknowledgement, whoever people has helped you, you mention their contribution in authorship. This is a customary and give a good gesture, and people can help you in future also. The references means references important to the readers, particularly those people want to again investigate on the basis of your work. Suppose you have done a study, use of metformin on particular condition. Okay. And you have mentioned these are the reference. I am a reader. I have read it. I am not very much convinced. What I'll do, I will see the reference from why you have done this work. Whether similar work is done by some other author. So I will see the reference, I will search the article, again I will read those works. If I see all the works, the methodology is correct, and their introduction, that is the why you have conducted the study, that is valid, then only I can accept your work. So reference is very important for the research purpose, also the readers who want to go ahead or you want to go to the next step after reading your article. So there are different methods of writing the reference, but we prefer the Vancouver style. Vancouver style means, just briefly I mention what is this. First come to the title, okay? Suppose Adams, title. then your other's name, Paul J. Then is coming to the year. Okay, suppose then article for, or you write the names, title, then names, abbreviation of the names. After three names, you can put et al. Okay. Or if it is less than three, you can put two. Then you write the whole article title. Then you title the journal's name. Then you write the year. Then you write the volume, then the page. So full name. Then you write the article title. Then you write the journal name, year, issue, then the page. This is style is called the Vancouver style. So there are so many reference style, but we Jima accept the Vancouver style. So guideline for the research writing is very important. Every journal in their online or in the offline, they print their priority, how they accept, or what should be the their standard of writing the article. When you are sending to a particular journal, it should be, for our journal we use, it should be very simple, clearly and concisely. Always use the common word. Do not use any difficult word. Follow instruction what we have given regarding the structure. Use subheadings to guide the reader. If you read the last few articles or few issues of the JIMA editorial section, I personally write, you have observed, I always put the subheading. Suppose quarantine in medieval period, quarantine in ancient India, quarantine in the British India. I always the subheading to understand. If I go on writing the whole issue, you may lose the interest or you may not follow. So always I put the subheading. Organize information carefully at all levels. Provide overviews before details. In the first paragraph, in editorial, you observe, I give the why overview. Why I have picked up this issue? What is the why you should know at 2020? You know what happens during the pandemic in 100,000 years back. Why that I mentioned in the beginning. There is the overview, and avoid very long paragraph. You will lose the concentration. Avoid very long sentence. The readers will lose the concentration. Define terms that might be unfamiliar to the readers. And remember to define. About this is a passive voice and writing. So ethics I already told. Ethics is very important, not to create any controversy. And revise after writing, you revise your work. Revise your work before sending. There is a checklist. You follow the checklist, download from the RT journal. And there is a also you see the checklist for the how the your article will be reviewed. That also you should know, because unless you follow the procedure, it will be rejected. In our journal, there is some review procedure. I'll tell later on during the discussion. And you submit the article as per the norms of the particular journal. This is the peer reviewed process. How we accept, how we decide. Any question regarding the peer reviewed process of our journal, please tell me. I will tell you. That will help you in sending more article to a JIMA, and definitely will not be rejected. So what is in our mind, I can discuss later on if you put the question. So publishing criteria and how to submit the journal. In my journal, now it is the online submission, mail we are not accepting online. And you can see the status also sending online. Whether it is accepted, rejected, and why the article has been rejected, that also you can status check. Site is there, you can check. Automatically you will get an acknowledgement number, and by putting the number, you can automatically check what is the status of your article. Thank you. I have taken a long time. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. It was a real wonderful presentation, and let me tell you that there were more than 72 participants listening to you, and a lot of information that we got, lot of motivation that we got from you. And I'm sure this will help many beginners to enter into this field of publishing. And as you rightly said, that there are a lot of barriers to clinical research and even publication. And the most important of this is attitudinal, where the attitude is missing and we need to work on that. As you rightly said, that we need to think of good journals where we can publish, but then I'm sure there are issues with publication. Not easily everything is accepted. So there are a few questions that I would like to ask you on behalf of the participants. Few I've got in the chat box, few I've prepared up front. So I would like to ask, what is the best way to, for a beginner, how can a beginner, what he should be doing? Whether he should be sending a viewpoint or a case report or a proper, what type of article he should be sending it to you so that his article is accepted for publication. Sir, you can unmute. Sir, please unmute.
For yes, the, sir. My suggestion is go for the pictorial CME or case report, because it is comparatively easy. And when, suppose you are, I am a postgraduate student, I work in the world, so I see very interesting city finding or X-ray finding, and it is easy to write also. And if it is accepted, that gives a boost to me that I can do more research, take a more longer time. So as a postgraduate, I may lose interest, or I may not have so much time, or if it take 5 years, that time may not be in the college. So I suggest first you start with case reporting.
Then you is there any prerequisite for a case report or a small case series? What does an editor look for in such a small case series?
In case series, two things. Either uncommon disease with common presentation or common disease with uncommon presentation. This is the two things we see. And I always see, when I accept the article, whether it is useful. Suppose I publish very uncommon things, I always keep it dumb. Because it will, if I publish some congenital disorder, something rarely, even I have not seen as a professor of medicine, I will not publish. I know it is hardly required, but I will see is a common issue in useful in day-to-day practice, particularly common disease with uncommon presentation, that as a practitioner you can miss. So I always focus on that part, not a uncommon presentation.
Absolutely. Something which is relevant and applicable in practice also.
In day-to-day practice.
Yeah. Another question is it very difficult for practicing doctors? Because not many of the participants here are into academics. So many of them are into private practice. And is it okay for them, or is it possible for them to think of starting to do this type of work?
Yes, for the general practitioner also, they can do the study. It is the basically they can do the observational study. RCT is not possible working in a chamber, but they can do the observational study. Simple things. Suppose I am getting some disease in some locality. John Snow, he is the father of the public health. What he has done? He just observed why in England, that is the Liverpool area, diarrhea is happening. You are a general practitioner of a particular field. You observe a particular disease. Why this disease is coming? Which population is coming? You are putting the record. And if you analyze just simple your observation, you will get a very good. That is more important than RCT. Observational study is the most important thing in clinical research.
Absolutely, sir. Another question is that many of us are afraid of getting a rejection. So, and if I get one or two rejections, then my whole tempo goes off. So what makes an article good article, or where is an article rejected?
No, that I described. Basically, article is rejected. Most important is the methodology. First, I see why you have done this study. Why the methodology was correct. Suppose methodology is not correct, then we have no option to reject, because then your observation is wrong. If methodology not correct, if your observation is wrong, then your discussion or conclusion will be wrong. So wrong message will go to the community. That is the most important. But what we do, when an article, my reviewer put 5-10 points, I have two way of reviewer. Suppose one article is rejected by the, directly rejected by the reviewer. What I do, I have some internal reviewer. She is also professor of medicine from some other college. I give to her. I tell her, you put the points, what are the lacunes, and you instruct to the author to re-research, to reconduct the study again and to send me after 6 months.
Okay.
So I always instruct like this.
So there is always a feedback given, and the person works on the feedback, then there is a chance that the article will still be considered if it is done in the right.
Yes.
So there is a question from Dr. Hemant Sant, who is a surgeon here. He says that how to publish a new surgical technique for a common problem, but with least number of cases.
With?
Less number of cases. Some new technique, new surgical technique for a common surgical problem.
Yes.
The least number of cases.
In my JIMA, you will see one section is your case discussion in medicine. This year, this month, I have put a autonomic dysfunction. How this present? Previously, I put a non-cirrhotic portal pharyngitis. Because I am physician, I get more article on medicine because most of my friends are physician. That is true. The one part. But surgeons, what they can do, some new technique, they put it as a case discussion in medicine section. Suppose this is the case. I told one of the cardiac transplant doctors who had done the transplantation. I told him, you write an article why you have done the transplantation, what is the indication and advantage, disadvantage of this. You write like this. So if you adopt a new technique, you send as a case discussion in medicine section.
That's right. And sir, when we are sending some case reports or case series, is it important that we take consent from patient?
If you want to put the picture of the patient, picture, yes. Photograph, face, that is required. And if you put the CT scan, some X-rays, ECG, it is not required.
And for some small observation studies or for online studies or some non-RCT studies, is ethics committee approval essential?
Yes, sir. Nowadays, it is applicable. But ethics committee means whether you study, I told, can create any turbulence to the society. Suppose you have mentioned this study, this disease more prevalent in particular religious group, that can create the trouble. So that is why ethical, but to get the ethical clearance from the observational study is comparatively easier. It is for the RCT, it is difficult.
Okay, sir. And sir, I understand that you represent JIMA, but if somebody wants to opt for different journals, what are the options, if you can suggest, and how to select the journal? So if I want to send some article, how do I decide that where should I be sending this?
Yes, that I also mentioned at the beginning. You have to understand two things in mind. One is what research you have done. Suppose you have, in JIMA is mostly read by the general practitioner. So suppose I have done a work on one or case report on the peripheral blood smear or simple or acute myocardial infarction. Or something on coronavirus. It is very useful for the JIMA because most of the readers handle this disease. Okay, but if you do some, if your study has some immunological part, have some genetical part, or then I will tell you, you send to the NEJM or BMJ or Lancet, because here reader cannot understand that immunological part or genetical part. So in this way you choose.
Right. So I understand, sir. And what it means by this is that we have to understand that the journal is catering to which type of readers.
Readers, so that is very important.
Article which is going to interest family physicians, then definitely JIMA would be one of the best journals. Similarly, if I have done some hi-fi research work where there's a lot of technical details, then it can be sent accordingly to that type of journal where genetics and other things are being taken into account. So I think it's a wonderful presentation, sir. We really enjoyed interacting with you also. And what I believe is that all the audience, all the participants who are here on this platform can at least initially begin with case report, case series, viewpoints, letter to editor at least to begin with. And those PGs who have done their thesis can think of publishing their thesis work. If it is done in the right format and right way, they can start even writing narrative reviews, clinical corners, images, as you said. Senior consultants can think of memoirs and would take up good prospective studies, simple, meaningful surveys, even retrospective data analysis based studies can be done. And sir, I would like to share with you at this point that at our department, which we have started very recently, last few months only, we have good infrastructure now. We have a registered institutional ethical committee. We have some funding which is assured for small research project. We have a website where we have a lot of interactive things happening. We have incentives for people who are doing their publications. We are doing a monthly journal club scan, monthly journal scan, blog, FB page, and a lot of other activities which we are planning to do in future, like the one that we did today. So we will take your help in future, sir, and we'll require you to mentor us whenever we are into trouble, especially for publication and other things. So
yes, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. I would
I request you all, you read Jima online, www.onlinejima.com. You send article online, and so many new section I introduced that is not present in any journal in India. Suppose I put the archive section or history section, the journal published in 19 before independence. Last year, last August is UFC. The editor, Jima editor, what is written on the eve of independence, 15th August 1947. That I always pass, I part, and you also send your comment, very important letter to editor, that will help us to improve. And thank you all for inviting me. Again, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you all participants.